Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. So today I'm gonna be going back to the reptile zoo, and this time Jay is gonna be there. I'm also gonna be meeting up with Jalen and Chris there. So if you haven't already, grab some snacks and sit back because today's video is gonna be awesome. So enjoy.
Hey, yo, there we are.
Half an hour.
Hey, there's traffic. Jay, you ready? What are we taking out?
We're getting out a big retic for you guys.
All right, let's do it.
You ready to have some fun?
I'm excited. Yo, it takes two people to carry this thing. This thing is huge.
Jay has all kinds of retics here, with kinds of more, all kinds of world's first and everything here.
This one's a world's first, right?
This is a world's first right here, guys.
Made plenty of world's first.
For sure.
We have a
Jay right here. We are.
Who's Jay?
Living the dream. This is Uncle Jay right here, if you guys don't know. Right?
Uncle Jay. I'll never live that one down. They're real tired of calling me. Call me Uncle Jay, and Uncle Jay it is. So you ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Guys, I don't have snakes, and starting off with this right here, look at that. I can't get any better than that.
Hey guys, this is gonna be his first snake, I'm telling you.
I don't know where it is. Where do I?
Right over here. I'm not responsible if he doesn't come back from this.
What if he eats me?
She's really tame. She is. You gonna go ahead and tell her? You know most about everything about her now.
So what's the morph of this one right here?
Sunfire. It's the first albino sunfire that was ever produced in the world. In the universe, or at least in this universe.
And of course, these are not out in the wild, right? Like this kind of morph?
Correct. So albinism was found in the wild, and sunfire was found in the wild. And this particular albinism is two kinds of albinism. It's amelanistic and then the P positive in one snake, which makes it the lavender face. And so it's actually three different genes in order to make this snake look this way. All the genes were originated from the wild, but not put together to this one.
And then with them being so tame, that's through breeding, right?
Of course.
Generation to generation.
Yeah, just like your dog. If you went out to where I just came from and you grabbed a dingo, you'd find out that wild dogs aren't so mellow.
Yeah.
So this wild snakes aren't necessarily so mellow either. Although I did pick up two diamond pythons out there and they acted like no big deal.
Really? They didn't bite you?
Nope.
Hey, look, I'm trying to be friends with you.
You have her parents as well?
I have to look at her records because she's already 10 years old. So obviously the parents of the parents are pretty old. So I don't know. I'd have to go figure it out, to be completely honest. I'm assuming I probably have at least the mother still.
Awesome. How many eggs do you normally get flushed from her?
So she lays about 45 eggs, which isn't a lot, but some snakes
that seems
genetically.
Seems like a lot, 45 eggs.
We had one lay 97, I think. But that's uncommon, but for her size, she's a big snake, so when they lay big eggs, they have smaller clutches.
How long is the incubation time for
the eggs? The hatching for the eggs takes about 82 days, 82, 84 days, depending on the temperature and all that. This is full today, it's Martin Luther King.
Everybody has a day off today.
That's
funny. Yo.
She's so tame.
Your hand looks tiny compared to her.
I don't think any of these little kids thought they're going to be petting a giant snake.
No. Yeah. Yo, why is it hissing like that?
As soon as I... What's
breathing.
That?
Breathing.
That's his breathing?
Yeah.
That's a big snake and you just got to exercise. So it's like it went to the gym. A lot of people don't understand, but just like a big person, when you go... do something for a few minutes, you're going to breathe a little bit heavier, and then on top of it, it's such a big snake that it's already breathing loud enough to hear anyway when it breathes normally. So if it gets it all winded, then you're going to hear it much more. And so she's not a little snake, that's for sure.
Yeah.
It's a giant lung. Their lung goes all the way past Jalen's knee.
So wow, you guys hear that?
What do they eat? Rabbits.
How many rabbits? Just one?
It can eat like.
Cause look at this.
How often do you?
2 12-pound.
Two 12-pounds.
We. I she probably yesterday. Ate a lot this week. Normally we feed about one a week.
One a week.
Oh, this is nothing. Just kidding. Guys, no joke. This thing is so heavy. At first, when I was just looking at it,
130 pounds.
I thought it was, and it also squeezed in my neck too. But I'm just still breathe. But this thing is super heavy. How much does it weigh, Jay?
I'd say about 180 pounds.
180 pounds?
It's like as much as you, bro.
Look at you.
It's like a rabbit.
All right, Uncle Jay, what do you call this?
I call this living the dream.
Living the dream, guys.
Are you shocked?
Bro, this is the biggest snake I've ever held in my life.
Okay.
Like, this is insane.
Now, you were
this
hoping I'd get out a big snake, but it's a bigger than you thought snake, right?
Yeah, I can't even carry this thing. This thing's like choking me.
So any time in your life when you get something cooler than you thought you were going to end up with, I call it living the dream, because you're not really thinking, you can't even dream that big. Look at supersized.
Yeah, this thing is super heavy.
You see what I'm talking about now? Okay, so Chris here wanted to get an idea of just how much a snake like this feels like weight-wise.
Whoa.
Right?
She is heavy.
She's got a little piece of hair on her face.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
So that's
this is a heavy snake, you guys. Wow.
That's what I was saying too.
It doesn't feel like any snake I've ever held.
No, I hope not. Look at that, what's wrong?
Wow. What's wrong, Chris? Why are you turning why are you turning red?
Why are you turning purple?
Okay, so we're gonna put her away. She's been out for a bit. Everybody got a chance to see her. We'd like to take her out, but she went with her to have a good time too. And she's been out a little longer than planned. So Juan, go ahead and let's put her back in her enclosure. She's actually starting to build follicles, so I can see that there's some eggs coming. So hey, if you guys are following, and you hit that subscribe button, you're probably going to see this snake sitting on some eggs before you know it. If I had to guess, about 90 days, 80 days from now would be my guesstimation. Anyway, thanks for following, you guys.
They're actually up there right now. See that?
Oh, wow.
They're all hanging out up there.
Wow. Alligator snapper.
Not want to put your hand in there.
Exactly.
Yellow anaconda. No. Yeah, yellow.
That's yellow.
Yeah, yellow. And then the green. Guys, check this thing out. What is it?
This is a sulfur water monitor.
This thing is insane and super tamed as well. Guys, like, this is so much better than a dog. Like, who would want a dog if you can get this, right?
This guy.
You have one too, right?
Yeah.
Is it this big?
No, about half your size.
Almost? Oh.
These guys are actually the second largest monitor in the world, right behind the Komodo dragon too.
It's like a little baby. Look at him.
So how big is yours, dude?
About 6 foot.
6 foot?
Yeah.
You say you can't wait until it gets this big, right?
Yes, this right here is Godzilla.
Right? Like, this is awesome, too. Like, they're so puppy tamed as well. Like, they can carry them like babies. Like,
exactly.
Your best friend right there.
Exactly. Love it. No
problem. But for one thing for sure, you gotta cut the nails, right?
Exactly.
If not, then you're gonna be like, oh, scratched up.
This one is not bad. I can deal with this nail.
Yeah, that one's not that bad, but other ones, like, oh man.
They can be.
Not on this one, though.
Nice. I have to wear like a jacket with mine because mine's cut me.
Yeah. All right, let's get some Aldebras in here.
Let's get it, guys.
These guys are a venomous species.
Venomous. Extremely venomous and dangerous.
So the winner, you have a problem.
You get hit by these, your whole arm will break out, you'll bleed to death, and then you'll throw up to death. So you guys do not want to get bit.
And it's so fast, like a cheetah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he bit me. First one.
All right, lunchtime.
Yeah.
Come over here. He has to work for it. Come on. Almost there.
He's a trucker.
He's like, no, you bring it to me. Is that one heavy?
Oh, wow.
Pretty dense, right?
Good gracious, yeah. Wow.
Jay, what did you do? Couldn't hold it.
No, you can wipe it with the lettuce, though.
The tortoise snapped at me and I freaked out.
Yo, buddy, what are you doing? No, over there. Over there, too. Oh, man.
Okay guys, thanks so much for watching this video. I had so much fun with these huge snakes here at Jay's place.
Those were medium ones.
The medium? What? Those things were like 300 pounds. I couldn't even pick them up. But guys, if you haven't already followed these two guys, follow my boy Jalen at
The Real Mowgli with three eyes.
And then you guys probably already follow him, but what's your username?
I doubt you are, but it's it's Prehistoric Pets TV.
There you go. So today's post notification shout out goes to
Billy Nolan. You're the man. You're living the dream,
living
baby.
Living the dream. Thank you so much for turning those post notifications. Whoever else want a post notification shout out, be sure to turn them on and then just comment down below when done so I know who has done that.
Make sure you're all living the dream, guys.
Living the dream. Okay, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace out.
Bye, y'all.